Have you always wanted to be one of those cosplayers where everyone fights to get your picture? Well, I am here to give you 10 rules to help you pick and create a cosplay that will be worthy of the masses. I'm a veteran at two of some of the biggest comic conventions, and I would choose a different cosplay each day over multiple days at every convention each year, and I have learned something about what the masses want to see. So I'm going to help you figure out what's going to give you the wow factor that's going to bring them in. Number one, get something that makes people do a double take. Things like Halloween contacts, man, these are gems. People love them. But make sure you get them from reputable places and not cheap overseas, or you'll be paying medical bills. This is rigid collodion. It'll help you make realistic looking scars. What you want to do is you take like a lip pencil, like a light pink, and draw where you want your scars. The pinker the color, the more fresh the scar looks, and the more flesh tone the color, the older the scar looks. And what you want to do is you want to trace over your markings, your scar markings, with this. It's just like fingernail polish, and it smells bad too. And paint over it, let it dry, and as it dries, it pulls your skin together and it gives you that divot that makes your scar real looking. It's awesome. And you can do a bunch of layers. The more layers you do, the more it's gonna pull that skin in and the more drastic that scar will look. It is amazing. And I once wore them together, made it look like I had a bad eye with a scar down there. I had one guy who thought it was all real. He thought that I picked my cosplay based so that it would match my real life injury, which I thought was awesome. So even if you don't have a super wow factor costume, these will bump it over the top, or even just some scarring. Make sure to get some of this. It's really inexpensive. You can get it on Amazon. I'll give you a link in the description. These are golden. Number two, the bigger, the better. If your character's something that could be made really big, then do it. That is a huge crowd pleaser. One example is Chewbacca. I'm sure you've seen a lot of Chewbaccas around, but I saw one that was humongously tall, and you can see in this picture how excited I was to get my picture taken with him, and so was everyone else. Another is I saw two groups of predators, same place, same day, and they both did a kickbutt job on their cosplays and all their details. But one group was a normal size person, and the other group made themselves bigger and taller and more formidable, and trust me, they're the ones that drew the fans. So if you have a character that can be bigger than life, then make it bigger than life. Something people can see over the crowd. Number three, make your accessories as authentic as possible. My sister and I have made arrows and quivers in the past, and we always use feathers from our chickens. Not everyone has chickens, but what I'm trying to tell you is be resourceful. If you need something that's like military-like, then go to the Army surplus store. If you have friends that have birds or pigeons or things and you need feathers, go to them. If you need fur or leather, then get the nicest faux furs and the nicest pleathers or real leathers that you can. Make things look authentic, and it will really, really sell your character. I've made a compound bow in the past from wood. Normally comic conventions don't allow wood weapons, but they were very nice to let me in. Anyway, you can paint them to make them look really real or aged, and I'll have a link in the description on that. Painting can go a long, long way to make things look really cool and give them that wow factor. Number four, make sure to use a character that people will recognize. One time I did something really obscure, and out of 100,000 people, 2 people recognized me. Now, if your goal is to bring the masses to want to take your picture, then 2 people isn't enough. So make sure that you do something that a lot of people are going to recognize. Number five, along with number four, don't pick something that's really overdone. Please don't do poison ivy. People have been doing poison ivy for decades and somehow they're still doing it. And it gets no attention because nobody really cares anymore. Harley Quinn is really overdone, but some people can still pull it off. Unfortunately, Harry Potter is also in this category. I learned this firsthand. I enjoyed dressing up as a Hogwarts student, but it really doesn't get you any attention because it is overdone. So unless you really look like Dumbledore, then don't do Harry Potter and try to find something that's not quite so overdone. Number 6. Try to either replicate your character the best that you can, as exactly as you can, and that's easier for people that already have some features going for them. But if you can't do that, or don't want to, then take a new take on the character, make it yours, give it a fun spin. Now, some things I could probably pull off pretty well, like a Snow White, or maybe a Wonder Woman, because I've got the hair, but there are a lot of characters that I really don't look like. So if I wanted to dress up like them, then I could do a fun spin on it. My sister is really a big fan of gender benders. She does a fantastic job on them. She did a kick butt job on her Jack Skellington. For those of you that don't know, gender benders, when you take a traditionally male character and change it into a female or vice versa. And she's done that with Robin Hood, she's done it with Link, and like I said, Jack Skellington, and she did a great job. So that's a really fun way to make the character unique and you and put a more fun spin on it. Number 7. Themed groups are always going to be bigger crowd pleasers than a singular cosplayer. If you can get a group together to go as a theme, then do it. If you have friends that cosplay and want to do it, that's great. If you don't have friends that cosplay, that's fine. Or if you have friends that cosplay and just want to do their own thing, that's fine too. All you have to do is get on social media on your comic convention page and say, hey, I want to do this character and I was wondering if any of you would like to join me in my theme and we can go as a group. Believe me, there will be lots of people that want to join you. It is so much more fun that way because you get to make new friends, have people to go with, and you're gonna have a lot more people begging for your picture. Two of my favorite group cosplayers that I saw was a group of Galaxy Quest team members, as well as two groups of Predators. Those were really fun. All right, number 8. This is one we gotta talk about. Wigs. Wigs, people. Wigs are okay, but you gotta do them right. Most people that use wigs are ones that are trying to make an animated character into a real life character, and it's just not getting pulled off right. So what you want to do is you want to get a wig that looks natural. Natural, please people, natural. You cannot take a Jasmine with a big black hair like this and put on a big fake looking wig and look beautiful and have that wow factor. You just can't. So any of you who are trying to replicate animated characters, whether it's anime or Disney princesses, whatnot, get a wig that looks natural. If at all possible, don't use a wig at all, because natural hair always looks so much more gorgeous. But I understand if you need to use a wig. Trust me, I tried to dye my hair white and it was the worst decision of my life because I had a year-long time of multicolored orange hair and it was the worst. So I understand the need for a wig. My sister did a great job on her Ariel. She had a beautiful red wig. She also had a beautiful white wig for her Jack Skellington. So if you need a wig, that's perfectly okay, but try to get a natural looking one. You can get them for fairly inexpensive. Amazon has some good ones for about $35, but don't get the over the top ones that are trying to replicate what's in an animated movie because it just doesn't translate. It just doesn't look good on you. True beauty and true wow factor comes from looking natural. If you haven't seen those beautiful photos online of people who drew pictures of Disney princesses and Disney princes as if they were real people, go look them up. They're gorgeous, and that is the look that you want to go for. Natural looking. So if you're trying to replicate an animated character, please don't go for those big fake wigs. Even my own daughters at Disney World weren't buying it. They said, "Mommy, those princesses, they don't look right. That doesn't look real. They don't look like the real princess." And that's because it looks fake. It looks bad. So you want to get a wig that looks natural. Please get a natural looking wig. Number 9, make sure your costume fits you. You don't have to be a size 1. You just need to make sure that your costume fits you. It doesn't matter if you're ordering it online or making it at home. Just make sure you're making those changes and alterations to where it fits you like a glove. The more believable, the better. You want that costume to look like it was made for you, not like you pulled it off the rack at a Halloween store. And number 10, make sure you pick a character that you love and are excited about. That's the whole purpose of cosplay, is to have fun and to be excited about what you're wearing and to show it off to people. Plus, if you've ever made lots of costumes, then you know how much time they take and sometimes how much money. So you want to make sure that you are willing to invest that kind of time and excited to invest that time, because if you're not excited about the character, you're not going to put in the time and effort to make it that wow factor. So pick something fun, pick something you love, and those people are going to be flocking to you. They're going to be asking for your photo. I'm telling you from personal experience, it is so much fun when everyone wants your picture. You feel like a celebrity and it is an absolute blast. If you like this video, hit the like button and please subscribe. We're going to do lots more cosplay stuff. I love cosplay. And if you have any ideas on or any experience on what has made your costume given it that wow factor, then please let me know in the comments, because I'm a cosplayer too and I want to know what's going to make my cosplay the best next year as well. I also have a Ultimate Harry Potter birthday video tutorial if you want to check that out. It involves lots of fire and magic, so check it out. Wow your kids, wow your friends, and see me in my Harry Potter Hogwarts uniform. I'll see you in the next video.